We're coming out of hyperspace. Everyone up front.
There's the fleet. I hope you're right about this.
Ah, look on the bright side. They open fire, and we'll be breaking the galactic record for going from zero to space dust.
Battle stations?
Wouldn't even scratch the paint on those cruisers.
Point taken.
Even if they don't shoot us down, handing us over to the Republic would probably help deflect the flak they've been getting.
I doubt the Empire's interested in doing the Republic any favors.
I guess, but they're putting up appearances for some reason. Better not take any chances. Hailing, they're transmitting a flight path. We're to dock in Hangar 8.
They aren't shooting at us. So far, so good.
Well, we're committed now.
My presence was requested.
I've been ordered to bring you before my lord, Darth Tormund. Submit to search and seizure and come quietly.
You trying to take me prisoner, Lieutenant?
If you attempt to resist, yes. You are under jurisdiction of this Imperial vessel, and I will not permit you to remain armed in the presence of a Lord of the Sith. You will comply, willingly or by force.
I'm not gonna be at your mercy.
Seize them!
You won't get away with this!
Quite a pile we stacked up.
So, do we make a run for it?
I came here to speak with the Sith. That's what I'm going to do.
I don't have a better suggestion. Let's do it.
Torian, secure the hangar and be ready for further instructions.
Understood. Koyashi.
I see you've disposed of your escort.
Can't say I appreciate Sith hospitality.
Start. Destroy what is mine again, and I shall return the favor.
Let's play nice with this one, please.
Today, Corellia's leadership swore allegiance to the Sith Empire. Despite total occupation, the people openly rebel. What should have been a bloodless victory has escalated into full-scale war. The Treaty of Coruscant is no more. I want the Supreme Chancellor's head in my hand when I deliver victory to the Dark Council. You will provide it.
What makes you think I'm gonna work for you?
Refusal would be unwise. If wealth and acclaim are not enough incentive, perhaps revenge will motivate you. You have made an enemy in the Supreme Chancellor's closest advisor. Do what I ask and you will have your opportunity for vengeance.
Don't give me a reason to change my mind.
So long as our enemies remain on Coruscant, they are beyond even your reach. But Jun Saras will not be difficult to draw out. Getting to him will put you within striking distance of the Supreme Chancellor. Corellia is where we will put them down. There are obstacles that must be removed before we can act. You will remove them.
Person, place, or thing?
Some old enemies from the last war have re-emerged. A Republic privateer made famous assisting Hilo Vis break the Mandalorians' blockade. And a Coati noblewoman credited with orchestrating numerous successful uprisings on Imperial-occupied worlds.
You want them back or gone?
They could prove useful, but leave nothing to chance if there's any risk of their escape. This star chart shows the last destination of your first target. Make it his final. My subordinates will brief you upon arrival.
Torian, you can stand down. I'll brief you when I get back.
I'll stand down when I see you if it's the same to you.
Mako, run this data.
All right, just one sec. Okay, I've updated our astrogation computer. This is a pretty obscure system.
Namba Owasasuga Kumanagaliaso?
Thanks, Blizz. I think I've got it. Last I'd heard, Belsavis wasn't even worth colonizing. The Imperials have it designated as a Republic prison world, though.
Poke around. I'm not in any hurry to visit yet.
I'll see what I can dig up, but I'm not optimistic.
Lieutenant Horn, Imperial Intelligence. I have orders to act as your liaison. I have prepared a briefing, should you require it.
Start from the beginning. I haven't been given a lot of details.
This is Zael Barrows. After helping break the Mandalorian blockade during the war, the Republic offered him considerable latitude to plague the Empire. Then, after the Treaty of Coruscant, the Republic retained him as their unofficial pheromone to Belsavis.
Why would the Republic hire a war hero to run errands?
Their operations here are strictly off the books. Using Barrows ensures nothing here can be traced back to the Republic. Belsavis is a remote ice ball with minimal natural resources, the perfect place to keep things you'd rather forget. Which is why the Republic has constructed a substantial prison fortress here to hide away their undesirables.
I assume we're talking about more than swoop gang scum.
Top organized crime figures, mass murderers, hostile species, political prisoners, anyone the Republic would like to disappear. That includes a large number of Imperial prisoners of war the Republic did not wish to release after the Treaty of Coruscant. Our landers can insert you into the Republic fortifications relatively near the last known location of Barrows' vessel.
I need any additional intel about the area.
You'll be heading for a starship hangar in the administrative wing. Expect resistance. We have already disrupted the Republic's ability to maintain control of their captives. The biggest threat to you will likely be the prisoners themselves. It will be absolute pandemonium, planetside. This is my direct holo frequency. I am on call, should you need me.
Secret prison fortress? Absolute pandemonium? How bad could it be?
What is it, Torian? I just landed.
Been talking to Horn. He's eager to make a good impression. Got him to give up intel taken from the Republic's operation. Made some connections. A lot of convicts have unclaimed bounties. Put together a list.
That was good thinking.
Thought you'd want to know. Nick's the small time, leaves a hit list from the exchange. Some gang pulled a major heist. Bounties for the lot. Last thing, save your carbonite. Nobody's wanted alive.
Sounds like Lover Boy's coming back. Ain't you gonna welcome him home? Hey, Zael! I like your plaything! Maybe I'll keep her a while! You ain't Zael!
Yikes!
Tell me where he's hiding, or I'm gonna crush Girly here like a bug!
I'd like to know the same thing. Who's the woman?
Zael's little girlfriend. Wanna kill her. But she's the only one left who can rat him out!
You can just shoot me. I'm not telling you anything.
Cooperate, and I'll get you out of this alive.
I'm not stupid. I'm dead. Zael, why'd you have to play the hero? I wanted to leave when the first siren sounded. Zael insisted we stay to help evacuate if things got too bad. Too bad. Understatement of the year.
Looks like that didn't go to plan.
The central power plant failed, and the hangar doors are closed. Even our ship can't put out enough juice to open them. We're trapped. Zael stormed off after some argument with a warden. Said he had unfinished business. He took M30B to get the central power plant back online. Said not to wait for him. That's all I know.
I can work with that. Find yourself a better hiding spot.
I can go?
You ain't going nowhere, girlie. And your boy's gonna hear all about how you died before I kill him.
I said she can leave.
And I said, she ain't walking out of here.
Last chance. Let her go.
Lucky I ain't got time to peel you out of that can. Run, girlie. But when I find you, I'm gonna see how much you can scream before your lungs go.
She was lucky we showed up when we did. I don't want to know what that creep had in store for her.
cut it a little close there, Em. Nice trap, you. I'd kind of hope the first time I met you, it'd be captaining your one-way trip to lockup.
Looks like it's the other way around.
Well, I'd love to go on a cruise with you, beautiful, but I'm spoken for.
Let me in there, you little twerp! You got nowhere to run!
This guy's got one answer to everything.
Friend of yours? Hate to disappoint. But even your thick skull won't break through this force field.
What are you standing around for? Let's blast this place to pieces!
How about I start with you, loudmouth?
Yeah? Give me your best shot. You wanna gut this twerp, go blast the stupid generators! Soon as this field drops, me and Zan are gonna get reacquainted.
If he's dead when I get back, I'm gonna be real upset.
Don't you worry. I plan on keeping him alive a good long time. Dirty rotten!
You let him get away, didn't you?
It ain't my fault! The rat scurried down this little hole while you were taking a sweet time wrecking the place! Tin Can wouldn't give up where he was going. Guess I broke it.
You can't beat answers out of a droid, moron.
Moron's what I call runty bounty hunters dumb enough to pick fights! I got an idea how to keep this heap talking. There's lots more junk like this thing, walking around keeping the runts in line. They get built at a plant deeper in. Bet there's parts to hotwire this trash and shock some answers out of it.
If this is a dead end, you're taking a one-way trip.
I ain't taking the trip yet. Place is inside Max Lockup. Ain't getting in there without some major boom-booms. And I only got this dinky piece. You blast the place up. I'll haul this junk over and grab us a couple of tech heads on the way. Deal?
Let's get down to it.
Come on, come on! Got you right where we want you now!
Thought I smelled something burning. Found us a couple volunteers.
You can't be serious. You want us to try and fix this? There's hardly anything here worth salvaging.
I only need to get inside its head. Find me something telling me where this man is going.
I think we can handle that. Dean, grab a diagnostic pad and a hollow emitter. This might take a little while.
Done all we can. If the Imperials want those prisoners, they'll have to crack them out of the tomb. It's out of our hands now.
You can evacuate, Warden, but I spent too many years putting those fiends away to let it all be for nothing. Come on, Em. We're heading to the tomb.
What's this tomb they're talking about?
Bust all the way out of Max to miss my shot at that twerp!
If the Empire has a plan for getting in the tomb, I know someone who can clue us in.
Ah!
My target's last known destination is something the locals are calling the Tomb. What can you tell me?
Unfortunately, everything we know about the Tomb comes from the Republic's limited records. It appears that most of the interaction the Republic had was with the Tomb's custodial droids, and only samples were normally allowed to enter.
What do you mean by samples?
Best guess, life forms, based on the contents of the vaults thus far. For what purpose? Your guess is as good as mine. We do know the Republic turned their Imperial prisoners over to the Tomb's custodians to prevent their recovery. All of our efforts are focused on regaining entry.
Put me in touch with your officer on the ground.
Commander Grang is in charge of gaining re-entry to the Tomb. He'll be able to give you the current situation. However you get through, if you can reach these coordinates, contact me. I'll bring you up to speed on any discoveries.
I'm coming along. I ain't been waiting this long for someone else to have the pleasure of killing Zale. You get me that twip, I show you where the law hides all the contraband on this rock. Deal?
Follow my lead, or I cut you loose. Got it?
Boss me around, huh? Fine. But your friend takes a hike, too. In case you're thinking you can pull something.
What? No way.
Do as he says, Mako. I'll be in touch if I need you.
Just be careful.
Horn, I'm in position. What have you got for me?
Analysis of data from the custodians is coming slowly, but I believe we found a solid lead. The bulk of the samples taken recently appear to have been interred in a vault we are designating Block 44. The majority of the Imperial prisoners have likely been taken there, making it the probable destination for your target.
And the remaining samples?
Operations Groups 1 and 2 identified a separate vault as the location of the Dreadmasters. Other samples were separated as well, though the reasons are unclear. Any of them could be a potential target, but our primary objective is the Dreadmasters. It's unlikely Barrows would go unnoticed. It's your call. These are Block 44's coordinates if you decide to pursue it as a lead. If Barrows is sighted elsewhere, you'll be the first to know. Horn out.
You know, twerp.
How did you... You are good. Nobody shoot. Truce. Look, we can settle our differences, but not right here. I have to stop the Empire.
I'm not buying whatever it is you're selling.
We've got you outgunned. If you want to fight, I can give it to you. You help us foil their rescue. Permanently. And I'll go quietly.
I try not to bite the hand that feeds me.
Can't blame a guy for trying. Fan out!
You're mine now, runt!
I was so close. So close!
I would know who you are and how it is you came to our rescue.
Darth Tormund hired me to deal with Captain Zale Barrows. Him.
Your master has my thanks. He will hear of your contribution to our cause. I am Lord Andreos Thos. We are what remains of Operations Group 1. Have our forces been able to free the Dread Masters?
The rescue operation's still in progress.
At least you've given me a second chance. We're standing on potential reinforcements numbering in the thousands. I must see to their release. Carry on with your business, but stay out of my way.
Been thinking about this since you dumped me on this rock, Zaley boy. Got it all worked out how you're gonna go.
Aren't you gonna do something? You came here for me. What about your bounty?
I'm delivering Barrows in the condition he's in.
We had a deal!
Consider our prior agreement void.
Fine! Lucky I still need you.
Thanks. I don't want to know what he had in store for me.
Better hope the Sith are feeling less creative.
You've been rubbing me the wrong way since I met you, but I'll let that slide if you do me a favor. I figured joining up with you is my best shot of getting off of this rock. What you say? I'll kill for you.
Bad chance, Psycho. I'm done butting heads with you.
You're wrong there. I'm leaving on your ship. With or without you. Get me?
If it gets me out of here, fine.
Smart. Real smart. Just get this little twerp out of my sight before I decide to crush him.
You're here to take Barrows off my hands?
I noted your return. I figured it was safe to assume you were successful, given your reputation. I prepared a report of your success for Darth Tormund. I have your compensation right here.
I could use a friend in Imperial Intelligence. Keep in touch.
So long as you're sure to put in a good word for me, I'll do that. I must return to my duties. Again, a pleasure.
Everybody front and center.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. What's that creep doing here?
What's the matter, girlie? Scared?
Torian's usually punctual.
Aw, let the kid have a day off. Better yet, wrap this up so I can get back to mine.
He told me he got a message from an old associate. They were going to meet at the cantina.
Out here? He tell you anything about this old associate?
Not really. You know Torian. You think this wasn't a friendly meeting?
He won't answer, or can't answer. I don't like either.
Should we head to the cantina?
You're starting to bore me.
Who do you think you are?
I'm scared. Don't forget it.
Whatever, creep. Can we get back to Torian now?
See if you can find that message from Torian's old associate.
You've been a busy girl. Too busy. You should spend more time with your loved ones before they're gone. I'm extending you an invitation. An opportunity to appreciate what you have before you lose it. But if you Mando barbarians don't care much for your POWs, it's not any loss to us. There'll be plenty of other opportunities for us to meet. If you want a chance to say goodbye, come to Hoth. We won't wait long.
Torian, we've got to save him!
Nobody messes with my crew.
Mess with one of us, mess with all of us, right?
Or at least humiliate them to death.
So what are we gonna do?
Set a course for Hoth.
Right. Let's do this.
I was starting to think we'd have to finish without you.
You've got no idea what you just got yourself into.
You don't say. Why don't you come a little closer and explain it to me?
Ambush, run!
You aren't saying anything your friend doesn't already know. You know, Grand Champion, you've got talent. The Overseers would have scouted you eventually. We could have helped you make a real mark on the galaxy. Now you'll have to settle for your gaudy title and the price on your head.
Better than the mark you're about to make in the snow.
Cocky and brutal. Just what I'd expect from Mandalorian scum. Bounty hunting isn't a game, whatever the Mandalorians think. It's serious business, with serious consequences.
consequences you're about to become intimately familiar with.
Sorry we're late.
Well, this is embarrassing. I owe you. Again. My turn to be bait, I guess.
You able to move out?
Definitely.
Hey, one of these creeps is still alive and kicking.
Oh, this should have been total overkill.
Despite what you think, the Great Hunt's no joke. There's a reason Mandalore made me his champion.
If this couldn't kill you, I don't know what would. I want out. I don't care how good the money is. It's not worth it.
You're begging the wrong person. Your call.
Torian, he's not worth it.
Dues paid. Finished?
You know, I was actually starting to miss you. Mako, get back and pull together some data for our next target.
Got it. Be careful, you two. Glad to see you both made it back okay.
Welcome back, kid.
Siki pinsi le kota kapota kinolona pizza?
Thanks. We back on the hunt?
I think it's safe to proceed.
One of Tormund's lackeys forwarded a star chart to a system called Voss. The place isn't even on most maps yet. There's a lot of scuttlebutt about Voss's discovery on the Holonet, but it's pretty far-fetched stuff even for spacer superstition. The astrogation computer's updated and ready to go when you are.
The Empire graciously welcomes you to Voss Orbital. Ambassador Yoren deeply regrets that he was unable to greet you personally. I've been instructed to emphasize the delicate situation you're walking into before you head for the surface. The Ambassador is concerned that your business could jeopardize the Empire's interests on Voss.
My employer would argue otherwise.
It's just that your kind aren't known for stepping lightly, you understand? The Voss are stubbornly isolationist and abundantly aware of their own value to the Republic and the Empire. It is vital that the Empire fosters goodwill. You must remain on your best behavior.
And just what is the planet's value, while we're on the subject?
Well, its location and some unique resources, but our lords seem particularly interested in its people and their connection to the Force. The Voss abhor discord and don't tolerate violence within their territory. You'll mix peacefully with the enemy here. The Voss revere their mystics. Deal carefully with them, or preferably not at all. Also, outsiders are barred from Voskar proper.
Pretend like I've never been here before.
Oh, I'm sorry. Mystics are the spiritual leaders of the Voss, healers and prophets. The Voss follow their visions without question. Outsiders aren't restricted from traveling the planet, but access to the Voss's home is restricted to the alien enclave. I will let Ambassador Yoran know to expect you. Head to his office once you've landed. Have a safe visit.
So we all have to play nice.
At least until we assess the situation.
I vote we enjoy whatever peace and quiet we can get.
You came promptly. Thank the stars. The less time you spend mixing with the locals, the better. I trust my aide was quite explicit in informing you of the need for discretion here.
I'm aware of your concerns, Ambassador.
You haven't heard half of my concerns, Bounty Hunter, but this business with you is at the top of the list. That said, I look forward to being rid of General Redrish. That woman will be the death of me, if you aren't.
I was told I'd be dealing with a Kuwati noble, not a Republic general.
They are one and the same. General Thelonia Redrish is a well-respected member of Kuwati aristocracy, a philanthropist, and a revolutionary. The Empire has lost a number of newly conquered worlds due to her interference, and we may well lose this one unless she's removed. Unfortunately, we're going to have to take the roundabout course. Push her into the open.
Any persons or interests she'd have a personal stake in protecting?
Imperial intelligence suspects that she's behind the guerrilla attacks on our forces here, but we can't prove it. I believe your best course of action would be to root out General Redrish's officers in the field and gather evidence of her involvement.
You have names? Whereabouts?
I'm afraid casualty reports are all we have to go on. You'll have to search around the ambush points for signs of the enemy. Take this holo recorder. If you make any discoveries, transmit the evidence to my frequency.
I'll check back in when I got something.
Perimeter, report. Perimeter. Those charges, Prime Sergeant.
Perimeter's on radio silence. Permanently.
Stars, that was fast. No time. Hit her with everything we've got.
It looks worse than it is. They were counting on the explosives to finish the job.
Finish nothing. There's enough detonite here to atomize their entire camp.
Right, maybe you should take a look at this.
Keep real still while I check this out.
I won't sneeze if you won't.
Fox Nest compromised. Full retreat. Operation Cave-In underway. Final transmission. Harrier 1 out. Harrier 1 to Peregrine. The garrison at Fort Cadenza appears to be sending out patrols of Imperial troops. Flights recalled and circling. What's the situation, General? Please advise.
Peregrine has to be General Redrish.
Harrier 1, expect more. Yoren's convinced the Voss to allow Imperial troops to bolster Voskha's defenses against the Gormak. Monitor their patrols. If they stray too far, show the Voss how ill-prepared Imperials are for Gormak attacks. Peregrine out.
That'll teach them not to scrub the drives.
I've got something for you. Transmitting now.
Now, what have we here? Oh, this is better than I could have hoped. I might even convince the Voss to hand her over for trial with this.
Are you putting me on standby?
You've done everything you can out there. Better we not tempt fate. I'll handle things from here. Return to my office and lay low until I return. Hunter, have you returned? Oh, never mind. It doesn't matter. Whatever you're doing, stop. I need you here immediately.
I can move as soon as you give me a destination.
I'm at the assembly hall on recess from our hearing. The Voss have agreed to hear the accusations I've made against General Redrish, but they've also agreed to her request to face her accuser. She named you specifically to be called to account and submit to questioning.
Definitely sounds like she's up to something.
She'll likely make a spectacle of you, but we don't have much choice. This is the Assembly Hall's location. Hurry, I don't want the Voss to think we're stalling.
I apologize that the Empire has decided to waste your time today.
You won't smooth things over with a smile this time. The evidence of your guilt is as plain as day.
Your holo recordings? I was really expecting you to have fabricated something a little more tangible, Ambassador. And your only witness is a known terrorist.
Never been convicted, but I'm not the one on trial here.
No, you're not. But your character is. You're a Mandalorian. Your people have made unprovoked acts of war against the Republic and conducted genocides against entire species. Do you deny it?
Wouldn't know. I just joined.
Tell us, how do you acquire this evidence of yours?
Your subordinates provided everything I needed.
That's preposterous. I won't stand here and listen to the Empire slander me. The Empire expects you to take the word of a hired killer instead of a respected official who's proven her commitment to the Voss people time and again. You will remember it is I who agreed to make the pilgrimage to the Shrine of Healing to show my solidarity with the Voss.
An idle promise. My associate can just as easily agree to make this pilgrimage.
Then take the trials, outsiders. That will reveal true character. We have concluded.
You have shown us much. Safe journeys.
Hedging my questions was smart. A shame the Ambassador had to open his mouth and seal your fate.
I've spent months preparing for the trials. They're going to kill you. Ambassador?
You shut her up right quickly. She wasn't expecting you to handle yourself so well. I'll requisition a little bonus for your performance. Keep it up. As to this trials business, I had to show the Voss we're willing to do anything the Republic will do. You understand?
Have you thought this through, or are you just blowing hot air?
These trials are obviously deadly. If General Redrish were not to return from her pilgrimage, it would hardly be unexpected.
I'll keep on her trail until an opportunity presents itself.
Faedith Kai is an influential figure at the Pilgrim Camp and is not hostile to us. See if he has any insight on getting you into this Shrine of Healing.
Outsider, my master saw your coming. He awaits in the Cloister of Meditation.
Who do I have to thank for the warm welcome?
Dokoth Ra, the Elder. You will see him.
Yeah, I'll see him.
The Cloister of Meditation is near, but secluded. Follow the silence.
Pilgrims are so few now, and outsiders.
People only grow by facing challenges.
The wise don't seek adversity. It will come. Change has come to Voss. Voss must come to change. The outsider woman you seek will be the agent of that change.
Is she planning something?
She believes coexistence with the Gormak is possible. But someone must give voice to it. I believe that voice is hers. You will not silence it.
Hey, what gives? You guys aren't supposed to be taking sides.
Stay in peace and leave in time. No harm will come unless you resist.
You break your neutrality, you'll regret it.
We are prepared for force. Restrain her? My gift is not foresight, but I see your fate is not for us to decide.
I'm a force of nature. The only smart thing to do is stay out of my way.
We cannot stop what must come to pass. The human woman has gone. She has left for Gormakos. Our hope goes with her.
Why stick your neck out for a stranger?
There are no words between Voss and Gormak, only violence. The outsider woman carries an offer of peace. Commandos stand vigil over Gormakos. Their commander may witness the outsider's passing.
Thanks for the information. No hard feelings.
A fool curses fate. Go in peace.
Outsider, rest. Take shelter. Return home. Only Gormak territory lays beyond.
I'm looking for a woman. Another outsider. She was headed for Gormakos.
She has found it. An outsider woman fell victim to Gormak attack.
The Gormak attacked. She surrendered.
She wasn't looking for a fight.
Normally, the enemy knows only murder. The woman was taken towards the Gormak beast pens. Her fate is sealed.
Show me where they took her.
I will point out the place. Be cautious.
Oh boy, I don't think we're the crowd favorite.
Kimaki ovadietochong. Amin swan gotrom babos. Ase, kidigwan nigor vos. Don voftaloren kiota voka. Anga! So ye fagor vote layan sum lata.
Hand over the outsider you captured, and nobody else has to get hurt.
Yisungin fan gramaklon, kacho den! Ne so fun de ko nagda neva de ak nagnan ni matan. Ve kum ni go danglang, chofei nakchong latamso.
Thank you.
Vlatan vam dao, dat rat vi bam laogron. Gronati boy kon koniga lampu.
You aren't the only ones who want to see her punished.
I kuni bam latam so goriti. No vada grusai, walei kon patron digai tupa.
Tell me where to find these doubters. I'll make sure she gets what's coming to her.
Huavaska, bam ki ngungham tromwan lao, the chao troksha.
Better late than never.
Vua wish say, hadram, la no vike guan vik kontui.
I'll show you the ropes, if it gets me out without trouble.
Vua ming guan, bam ji wan guamak ki lan va.
Got the hang of this pretty quickly. Shame I can't stick around.
Then foi futakan achnan chok tontai. Vebegor nesafun. No vada grusai. Walei kon patron digai tupa. Then foi futakan achnan chok tontai. Vebegor nesafun. Niko woi tapwai chakamrang. Kongi.
I'll try not to lose my head. I expected we'd cross paths again, but not here. You're keeping interesting company these days, General.
It's not hard to find people who share a desire for peace and prosperity. A Mandalorian wouldn't understand.
I'm so close to getting these people on speaking terms, and you're about to throw it all away. For what, money? Tell me you're not that petty.
You're between me and a man spouting lies. Nothing personal.
I think that's a small sacrifice for peace. Nothing personal. Show her what you're made of. Wait! Cease fire! This is a losing battle.
If you're giving up, get on with it.
You've done all you can. This is my fight to lose. This is a pivotal moment in this planet's history. I won't let our squabbles get in the way. If you'll allow these Gormak to return home, I'll lay down my weapon.
You're going to sacrifice yourself for perfect strangers?
No. I'm going to keep them from sacrificing themselves for something as insignificant as my life. Jedi and Sith waged war here centuries ago, both manipulating these people into fighting their battles for them. It's all painted here on these walls. Now, we've come full circle. These people deserve better than to be exploited by galactic politics. Give them a fighting chance.
Couldn't care less about the Gormak.
You think they'll really make peace? I hope so.
Thank you. Go. Others need to know what we found here. Do what you came to do.
I don't need your permission.
I had her pegged all wrong.
We're done here. I've captured General Redrish.
You're back! Oh, I hadn't heard one word since you left for the trials. I thought she'd got the best of you. I suppose no news is good news in this case. If you'd raised any suspicion capturing her, I'd have heard about it. Whatever General Redrish's plans were, it seems we've avoided the fallout.
I'm sure my payment will reflect the extra care.
This is the most relieved I've felt in months. I might even actually sleep tonight. Take this with my gratitude. It'll complement the sum of credits Darth Tormund sent quite nicely.
Your gratitude is appreciated, Ambassador.
I'll send word of your success to Darth Tormund promptly. Farewell.
My subordinates tell me that you dealt with the privateer and the Coati woman.
Lieutenant Horn and the Ambassador were a great help.
Noted. The campaign on Raban is coming to a close. I will direct my forces towards a full-scale assault on Corellia. Rendezvous with my flagship, the Tyrant, in Raban's outsystem.
I am Captain Evelyn, commanding officer of the Tyrant. You are Darth Tormund's bounty hunter?
I don't answer to Tormund, or you.
Then consider this an urgent request. Republic Special Forces slipped on board during our troop withdrawal. They've completely overrun the command decks. It won't be long before we lose the bridge. If you act quickly, we might be able to turn things around.
Darth Tormund can't handle this himself?
He went to deal with the attackers personally, but his soldiers are sealed off from the bulk of the fighting. The borders initiated a complete lockdown, trapping our defenders and the subdecks. I need you to undo their tampering. With their overrides disabled, we can unseal the lockdecks from the bridge, so Darth Tormund and his soldiers can retake control.
Give me the where and how.
I'm transmitting the location of the ship's network junctions. Restore the systems and we can handle the rest. I've opened the docking bays and disabled our weapons. You can make a safe landing if you hurry. The window of opportunity is...
Now or never.
If we're going to land, we better do it before the borders get the turbo lasers back online.
We're in for a rough landing.
Business as usual, then?
Figures I'd have a big lunch.
You must be the bounty hunter Captain Evelyn contacted. Thanks for the rescue. Once they killed the captain, we thought the fight was as good as done.
I've had way tougher jobs.
We aren't out of the fire yet. We need a few minutes to override the lockdown, but we're finished if we have to hold off another attack. Will you assist in defending the bridge?
Anyone stepping through that door gets blasted back out.
Get those lower decks unsealed, ASAP. My lord, it's a relief to see you unscathed.
Where is Captain Evelyn?
The captain's dead, sir, my lord.
And yet you avoided his fate.
Yes, I mean, no. We were sur-
Well, I'm not sleeping tonight.
I have you to thank for a ship.
You can add this to my bill.
So be it. Have this ship operational by the time we are finished. I am mobilizing my entire division to Corellia. Their rebellion will be crushed. Corellia will fall, but military victory will not be enough. I do not want the Republic merely defeated. They must submit.
A win's a win.
We will not make martyrs. The people will see their heroes broken and their Republic fail them. There is a massive resistance supporting the Republic's defense of Corellia. You will secure the rebel leaders. I will make them kneel. When the rebellion bows before Corellia's rightful leaders, our trap will be set.
What's the rebellion got to do with June Saros and the Supreme Chancellor?
If Corellia is conquered, the Republic will send troops. If Corellia secedes, the Republic must rely on diplomacy. A compact will be signed publicly. Corellia's governor will demand that the Supreme Chancellor ratify the treaty and withdraw Republic forces. The Supreme Chancellor will have to acknowledge that the Corellians have chosen Imperial rule, but not before June Saros convinces him that his Jedi can turn the tide.
I've only seen Saros operate through proxies.
He was undefeated on every front he led during the last war. He will not sit idle while Corellia falls. I have sent my forces ahead, under command of General Crow. Meet with him and proceed according to plan. When the Tyrant is hyperspace capable, I will join you.
Renly.
Let's get on with this bounty hunter. I've troops to deploy. Darth Tormund demands that I dispatch you to capture Chairman Harlan Fane of the Corellian Corporate Council.
Where can I find Chairman Fane?
Fane and the other representatives have locked themselves up in their council tower in defiance of Imperial rule. His exact location isn't known, but it is likely that he and the other senior representatives are holed up in the tower's upper executive offices.
I imagine there's more than a few locked doors involved.
Weapon emplacements, prototype droids, and a private security force of ex-military contractors armed with the best equipment money can't buy. Resistance will be heavy, but the Council Tower has several structural weaknesses we can exploit. The only thing stopping you from accessing the tower through the main lobby is sheer manpower.
So what you mean is nothing's preventing me from accessing the tower?
If battling heavily entrenched soldiers one flight of stairs at a time is no trouble, be my guest. The executive suites have a private lift that will bypass most of the intervening levels. It'll require an access key used by senior staff. Also, unless you'd like to be trapped inside a lift shaft, you'll need to attack the tower's security center and disable their lift override controls.
If there's nothing else, General, I'd like to get started.
Once those objectives have been completed, you should have a straight shot to the upper levels. And remember, you're to deliver Chairman Fane alive and intact. Dismissed.
Wait.
Sir, they're dangerous.
Guys, I'd let your boss do the talking. Trust me.
I see they're obviously not Imperial soldiers. This is clearly a question of money, not loyalty. Am I right?
I've got my reasons for being here. Money's only one of them.
Look, I'm a powerful man. I can open a lot of doors. Let's work something out. The private sector always needs good talent, and we'll pay you what you're worth. Why collect one paltry bounty when I can pay you a fortune in regular wages?
Take care of the Republic's price on my head, and we'll talk.
A fresh start? Harder to grease the right palm since the Prime Minister sold out to the Empire, but it's possible.
Hey, what gives?
It's you! Fire! Fire! We can work this out. The Empire can have Corellia. I'll slip off world and retire somewhere in the colonies.
Make me drag you out of there, and they'll have to shoot your next press conference from the neck up.
Don't hurt me. I'm unarmed.
I can't stop you. I'll go quietly.
You've obtained Chairman Fane. Good. We proceed on schedule. General, see to the bounty hunter's reward.
Yes, my lord.
Our next objective is to bring Corellia's beasts to heel. You will be the one to break them.
How do you plan for me to do that?
The Corellians cohabit with a number of species. The most numerous and organized are the Salonians. The Republic needs to see the Salonians accede to the Empire. A representative must be acquired.
Never seen a Salonian. What am I looking for?
Man-sized vermin with enough intelligence to fear us. They support the rebellion from Coronet City's interstitial maintenance corridors. One particularly tenacious animal leads packs of raiders to undermine our front lines. It will make as good an example as any. General Trow will brief you on the battle plan. When you have the creature, bring it to me in Axial Park.
Got someplace more important to be?
I lead from the front. Do not keep me waiting.
Trying to locate the Salonian raiders in the guts of Coronet City would be almost futile. Instead, you'll target an invaluable Salonian resource and force these raiders to defend it.
What's important enough that they'd risk fighting on our terms?
Salonians rely on a small breeding caste to reproduce. With their future at stake, the Salonians will have no choice but to act. Raid the Salonian warrens under Labor Valley, take your hostages, and hold them at these coordinates.
There's no glory in bullying the weak.
Once you begin pulling the mothers from their dens, even the civilians will attack you with unmitigated ferocity. These shock collars will keep the alien filth in line while you lead them to the ambush coordinates. When your objective is complete, report directly to Darth Tormund in Axial Park. Just follow the sound of destruction.
I hear you're quite the fighter. Let's settle this personally. Winner take all.
This isn't our proudest moment.
They're only here to get your attention. There's only one place scrapping with the Empire gets you. Then I'm sorry I have to do this. Nothing personal. Your representative, Darth Tormund.
Impressive. For an animal. The trap is nearly set. All that remains is to capture the last figurehead of Corellia's old regime. Corellia's Civil Police Force Commissioner. Somehow Commissioner Carter survived the initial purge of dissenters before Prime Minister Falcone delivered Corellia to us.
I'd have thought Corellia'd be under martial law by now.
CORSEC was disbanded, officially. One of the many steps taken to ensure a smooth exchange of power. It failed. Since the purge, Commissioner Carter has rallied the rebellion. The public sees him as the last legitimate voice of the Corellian people. Carter and his CORSEC officers are the backbone of the civilian resistance.
CORSEC is one thing, but I'm not keen on dragging any more bystanders into this war.
It will not be an issue. CORSEC's old headquarters is now a formidable fortress. Our forces are laying siege to it as we speak. Their standing orders are to block off any escape. That is all.
I won't be calling for backup.
Contact me when Commissioner Carter is in custody. My troops will cover your exit.
Well, look at you. Waltzing in here like you own the place. Come to finish what they started? Go on and kill me. You'll have a million citizens rioting in the streets by sundown.
Huh. Guess I'd be in real trouble if I were here to kill you.
If you aren't out for blood, why are you here?
I'm a bounty hunter. What do you think?
I think you're greedy, amoral scum, here to sell me to the highest bidder. Imperials, I bet.
People you're working for, they aren't spice runners or thugs looking for a quick fortune. They're despots. Do this and you'll force billions of people to bow before the Sith. Is the Empire paying you enough to clear your conscience of that?
Better they bow than continue getting caught in the crossfire.
Well, aren't you just a darling? Thanks for the chat. Now I know that what I've been doing is making a difference.
Hit him!
Where are you? I can't see.
You got me. Good for you. You want a medal? You and me, this battle, the war, not even a blink in the grand scheme of things. Corellia has been around a lot longer than the Sith's little upstart empire, and it'll be around long after the Empire falls.
I make do with the here and now. Tormund, the Commissioner is secure.
Good. Our forces have control of the Corellian legislature. Deliver Commissioner Carter to the Grand Assembly. Your reward will be waiting.
Prepare the Commissioner for the surrender.
My lord!
Your success is noted.
Anyone else you're planning to add to this gathering?
Your work is done for now. Enjoy the fruits of your labor. Watch these rebels sign our enemy's death warrant.
Might as well see this through.
Supreme Chancellor Janaris, respected members of the Galactic Senate, the Corellian people have chosen. We will not continue to be held captive by a failed system. I demand that Supreme Chancellor Janaris ratify this treaty and acknowledge Corellia as a sovereign system of the Sith Empire. It was only a matter of time. As Prime Minister for Life, let me be the first to welcome you to Imperial Corellia, my lord.
Had you delivered what you promised, you would enjoy a longer reign.
That how you conclude all your business?
When the agreement is not upheld. Now, we wait.
Darth Tormund desires your presence immediately. This way, please.
A large Republic fleet has entered the system. It includes the Founder, Supreme Chancellor Janaris's personal flagship. These reinforcements are attempting to consolidate the Green Gardens. You know who leads them.
Seros has been spotted?
He is a conspicuous leader. Jun Seros seeks to urge Coronet City's Green Jedi out of their enclave and press the attack. When their forces are amassed, the Republic will attempt one last offensive. You have until then to reap your vengeance.
I work at my own pace.
If Seros leads his attack, he will die. I will not surrender ground for your vendetta. Attacking Jun Seros within his headquarters is the only way to be sure crucial data is in his possession. Dispose of Seros, quietly. No one must know of his demise. Bring his effects to me.
An intruder!
Go. Do your part to liberate Corellia. This is a private matter.
You don't want to get in the middle of this.
Are you certain, Jun?
You know what's required of you. Go.
As you wish.
May the Force be with you.
You're persistent. Stubborn. I suppose that's why you excel at what you do, but the price is high. What won't a Mandalorian put aside for pride?
I'd meet death head-on for a comrade.
But would you kneel?
You chose to murder Kelly and Jarl, just like you chose to kill everyone sent to bring you to justice. You could have surrendered at any time. You chose to become a murderer and terrorist. I only turned all that senseless destruction toward a righteous purpose.
Killing my associates and slinging mud. Real noble.
They made their decision, just like you made yours. If using you to expose the Sith's true face has dirtied my hands, so be it. It's time to answer for your crimes.
You read my mind.
I won't be the one after all.
Now whose pride's getting them into trouble?
Savor your vengeance. It's a small victory. You've denied me nothing here. In failure, I've undone all your accomplishments. In death, I return to the Force.
I thought Jedi were supposed to be detached. Why'd you make this personal?
If you believe you can distance yourself from the harm you cause, you're deluding yourself. You're not some mindless tool. You're accountable. Your actions will catch up with you eventually.
Pathetic. I did not see Saros. You were successful?
Take a look for yourself.
Only Jedi would call something this fragile Battlemaster.
Battlemaster some sort of special honor?
Before our return, Jun Saros taught all Jedi the art of conflict. His death is a crippling blow to the Jedi Order. And without Jun Saros at his side, the Supreme Chancellor is exposed. Victory is close.
Gonna pay for that, or browse all day?
Your compensation will be appropriate. Once the encryption is broken, we will know this data's true value.
You know more than you're letting on.
Jun Saros came here aboard the Founder. He was privy to its security protocols, landing codes, even the Supreme Chancellor's itinerary. My subordinates will transmit the relevant data to your vessel when it's prepared. Until then, make yourself useful to Darth Decimus. The battle for Corellia is not yet decided.
The Jedi are broken. The Republic forces are in disarray. Now is the time to strike. You will depart Corellia. Make for the Founder, the Supreme Chancellor's flagship, immediately. The Founder's landing codes will give the Republic fleet little reason to fire upon you.
You think they'll just let me fly right to the Supreme Chancellor?
The Republic should expect deception. We must make things convincing. Captain Horn has prepared an SOS signal using the Republic's ciphers. When you leave the spaceport, you will be pursued by our ships. The Republic will allow you to board, or they risk allowing one of their own to die. We will give them no time for doubt.
Will your pilots know I'm on their side?
Their orders will be to stop you at all costs. I expect you can handle it. You will reach the Founder by any means necessary. Once on board, your first priority will be to destroy all crafts in the adjacent hangars, to prevent the Supreme Chancellor from escaping.
Does Cyrus's data specify what's docked in those hangars?
Leave nothing to chance. Destroy anything capable of spaceflight. With no means of escape, only the Supreme Guard will stand between you and your prey.
Time to see if the Supreme Guard live up to their name.
I will await you on the Tyrant. The Supreme Chancellor's fate is sealed.
So many people willing to lay down their lives for me. It should never have come to this. There's something I want to tell you before you do what you came to do.
It's not every day I get to chat with the leader of the Free Galaxy.
I'd ask you to sit, but I prefer not to kid myself. I reviewed the report surrounding the operation to apprehend you. It's atrocious. A monumental abuse of power. I don't condone what you were doing, but I understand it. It was just your job. June made it personal.
June paid his debt to me in blood. I hope you won't make the same mistake.
That's exactly what I wanted to speak with you about. I've already declassified the real details of yours and June's actions to the public. The fallout will be tremendous. No matter how our meeting concludes, I'll be removed from office.
I'm sure it wasn't easy to come clean, knowing your career would be sunk.
June had no right to deceive the public, and neither do I. The people must be able to believe their leaders. The false accusations will disappear as the truth is separated from the lies. It's not a clean slate, but it's what you deserve. I'm willing to take things a step further, if you're willing to work with me.
One good turn deserves another. What are you offering?
Immunity. If you're willing to show me you're not firmly in the Empire's pocket. June believed you were in league with a Sith named Tormund. Is that true?
We have a partnership of convenience, that's all.
It's a partnership you should end. Tormund's a monster. His troops have been butchering Corellians. On Raban, he flattened kilometers of homes, businesses, hospitals. A man like that can't be given more power. Let's fix this while we're in a position to do so.
Well, we haven't had much choice about working with Tormund until now. This could be our out.
Tormund's had us under his thumb for too long. Keep your word, and Tormund will disappear.
It's time to show him who's boss.
I understand the risk you're taking. Thank you.
The Supreme Chancellor has been dealt with.
Good. Make for the Tyrant. The fleet will cover your escape.
We'll engage the Imperial fleet, but I'll have to survive this to hold up my end of the bargain. If you can somehow cripple the Tyrant after dealing with Tormund, we can handle the rest.
The Tyrant won't trouble you, Chancellor.
You reek of vengeance and satisfaction. The Supreme Chancellor's death has excited your passions. Relish it. Experience some small measure of what it is to be Sith. Now, deliver what I have asked of you.
I'm done dancing to your tune, Tormund.
I expected better. This was deserved.
Rule with a clenched fist. You better be prepared to scrap.
Trusting in a tool, however useful, was a mistake.
the task of delivering the masterstroke I should have reserved for myself. The galaxy would know. None are beyond my reach. All would cower or they would burn. And the Dark Council would see how total victory is achieved.
Even Sith don't get everything they want.
I was hoping to find you alive. Quite a narrow escape. Darth Tormund was not as fortunate, I trust.
I took care of him, personally.
Good. At least it's done. Perhaps it's best that I'm getting out of politics. Ranging assassinations couldn't be farther from what I've stood for. After falling this far, I suppose there's no point in trying to recover my principles. Coming clean would only do more harm than good.
You don't cast off honor when it's inconvenient.
I never said I was excusing my failures. Only living with them. It was for a greater good. We may be far from achieving peaceful coexistence, but the fewer men like Tormund that come to power, the better our chances. As far as anyone knows, Tormund died in a foolish naval battle. Let's leave it that way.
You're a good man, Chancellor. The Republic will be worse off without you.
I'm glad you weren't the monster June made you out to be. You'll be exonerated as I promised. Even if my replacement questions the justification, overturning it would be more trouble than it's worth. I'm also sending a small reimbursement for your lost wages. It isn't much. There are more important things than pride and wealth. I hope you'll continue to use such good judgment in the future.
I'm a Mandalorian, Chancellor. We may not follow your rules, but we've got our priorities straight. You may not know how to handle a blaster, but you're prepared to die for what you believe in. That's good enough for me. Live in honor, Chancellor, wherever you end up.